Hello everyone. So now we'll see about the different levels of the parallelism. So first one, the instruction level of a parallelism. So in this, the fine grained or a smallest granularity level typically involved less than 20 instructions per grain. The number of candidates for parallel execution varies from 2 to thousands with about 5 instructions or statements being the average level of a parallelism. So on an average it will be like 5 instructions or 5 statements being the average level for the parallelism. So the advantage is there are usually many candidates for a parallel execution. Compilers can usually do the reasonable job for the finding the parallelism. So second one is loop level parallelism. So in this, typically loop has less than 500 instructions. If a loop operation is independent between iterations, it can be handled by a pipeline or by a SIMD machine. Most optimized program construct to execute on a parallel or a vector machine. Some loops are difficult to handle. Loop level parallelism is still considered fine-grained computations. So the next one is the procedure level parallelism. So in this, it having the medium-sized grain, usually less than 2000 instructions, and the detection of parallelism is more difficult than with the smaller grains. And the procedural depends, analysis is difficult, and history is also sensitive. The communication requirement less than instruction level is SPMD, that is a single procedure multiple data, is a special case. Multitasking belongs to this level. So next one, a sub-program level parallelism. In this, job step level is grain typically has thousands of instructions that may be medium or coarse grain level. Job steps can overlap across different jobs, that is multi-programming conducted at the level, and no compilers available to exploit medium or coarse grain parallelism at a present. So next one is job or program level parallelism. So here the corresponds to execution of essentially independent jobs or the programs on a parallel computer. This is practical for a machine with a small number of powerful processor, but impartial for a machine with a large number of simple processors. So now we'll see about the communication latency. So this balancing granularity and the latency can yield better performance in various latencies attributed to machine architecture, technology, and the communication patterns. So here there are different machines architecture and technology, and the communication patterns used are, so latency imposes a limiting factors on machine scalability, Example, memory latency increases as a memory capacity increases, limiting the amount of memory that can be used with a given tolerance for the communication latency. So first one, that is the inter-processor communication latency. So it needs to be minimized by a system designer. And the second one, it is affected by a signal delay and the communication pattern. So if take example, a communication task may require n into n minus 1 divided by 2 communication links, and the complexity grows quadratically, okay, effectively limiting the number of processors in the system.